Yo, what's good, Tristans?
And Tristan!
Today, we're going to be reacting to Olivia Rodrigo, Good For You, I believe, off of her documentary that she has on Disney Plus, which I actually thought was really, really cool. I skipped over songs that I thought would be good to react to because they seemed unique. I remember this one I skipped over because it's like with an orchestra or something. I was like, anyway, that seems interesting. So, anyway, before we get started, be sure to check me out on Instagram, TikTok, Patreon. On my Patreon, by the way, I've reacted to almost all of season one of High School Musical, the musical, the series. You can go ahead and check that out if you're interested. Anyway, let's go. Okay.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks.
Okay.
Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? For you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the
what
therapist
the
I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl.
Okay. I wonder how this is gonna go.
Good for you, you look happy and healthy.
So pretty.
If you ever care to ask, good for you, you're doing great out there without me, baby. God, I wish that I could do that. I've lost my mind, I've spent the night crying on the floor of my bathroom.
You know what's weird? This is actually the most, let's say, belty and most intense I think I've ever heard her actually sing this song, and it's over an orchestra. I really wonder if like doing this over like a bunch of really loud guitars and stuff kind of like messed with her a little bit. Also maybe having the in-ears, not being able to hear yourself, all these things. But that's very interesting to me. Her vocals here are perfect, actually.
Good for you, I guess you're getting everything you want. You bought a new car.
She's dressed a little bit like a granny.
Thinking off, it's like we never even happened, baby. What the f is up with that?
Ooh.
And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when
that's a good outfit, though. Before y'all get mad at me.
Screw you, you will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. Well, good for you, you look happy and healthy. Not me, if you ever care to ask.
Dude, the amount of power that she's able to get in this chorus, I swear, is way more than I've heard from her before. Like, for example, let's pull up the Saturday Night Live performance of the same song. I think this was the first time she performed the song live. Could be wrong, though. There's a lot of, maybe it's a stylistic thing. It could be a stylistic thing, but there's a lot more here of...
And out me, baby. God, I wish that I could do that.
Where it's she's doing a lot more of this like held back sound in her voice. There's more air, especially in the bottom of her voice. And overall, the volume is way quieter. I wasn't imagining it. And then we jump to this. See if we can find the same line. There's
without me, baby. God, I wish that I could do that.
Right? What do we have here? It's lighter, although the pitch here is higher as well. So when the pitch is higher, it makes it a little bit easier sometimes when the pitch is so high to sing it lighter the way that she is. It's so interesting. Her voice has changed so much, but it's changed so slowly and so progressively, you don't really notice it. It's pretty interesting. I wonder how she's gonna do the sociopath line. I think that's also going to be a nice section where we can jump back and forth a bit. Sorry for pausing so much, but it's interesting to me.
So affected, I really don't get it, but I guess good for you.
There's a little bit of a, really don't get it, but I guess good for you. Right? Trying to make it kind of dramatic for you guys, but then we jump to here. And here, instead of get, she's going, get it, but I guess, right?
Good for you.
Although the yeah, ha, ha is the same. For the most part, although she's again a little bit lighter in the Saturday Night Live performance. I do think she was a little bit nervous in the Saturday Night Live performance, and also it was one of the first performances of the song, and also I think it was her first TV performance. I know way too much about her. I'm realizing as I'm watching this. So, you know, There's all these different factors playing into it, but I do think that her voice is getting progressively more and more powerful. I think a big part of that as well, she's been playing with this like punk band kind of a thing, and a lot of her songs are sort of changing up and developing in a more aggressive way. It's pretty cool. The next thing I want to hear from her is some distortion, but that's another story. Some like false full distortion, some like ah. All right, take it away, orchestra.
Maybe I'm too emotional. Ooh. Your apathy is like
a... I was going to say, I feel like they're going to pluck the strings, are they?
So, maybe yes. I'm too emotional. Maybe you never cared at all. Maybe I'm too emotional.
Sociopath line. Best part of the song.
Maybe I'm too emotional. Maybe you never cared at all.
I was gonna say they better not play the sociopath line.
If you ever cared to ask, good for you, you're doing great out there without me.
I love this change.
Like a damn sociopath, I've lost my mind. I spent the night crying on the floor of my bedroom. You're so affected, I really don't get it, but I guess good for you.
Woo! Beautiful. I think also, sorry to keep pausing it, but I think also something that I'm noticing about her is she's having a much easier time as she goes on and gets used to live performances and stuff, letting the sound kind of just come out of her, if that makes sense. A lot of people, when they think of breath support, they think of, oh, you need to clench, you need to hold, you need to, but sometimes it's really not about that. Sometimes it's really the opposite. It's a good idea to try and let the sound move, let the air move. Actually use more air as opposed to hold it all and clench it in. I'm not hearing a lot of places here where she's not doing that. Like her air and everything is just flowing so easily. It's like it's just coming out of her, which is beautiful. Love seeing that.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily.
That was cool. But yeah, this documentary is really neat. I think I'm probably gonna do Favorite Crime, and I think that's gonna be it, because that's one of my favorite songs. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure you subscribe, bell notification on, obviously. Check me out, Instagram, TikTok, Patreon. And like I said on Patreon, I've already reacted to, I think, 8 episodes of season 1 of High School Musical, the musical, the series, and I'm probably moving to season 2. We'll see. But, I mean, it's gonna be hard with season 3 coming out soon. I almost have to do season 2. But anyway, hopefully you guys enjoyed my reaction, and I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye!